let's go to the second topic. That is to understand what are the key factors affecting the pricing decision. Well, there are two set of factors. One, the internal factors. Second, the external set of factors. Let's look into each one of it. Under the internal factors, they are organizational factors, the marketing mix, product differentiation, cost of the product, and the marketing objectives. Well, what do we mean by that? The first concern being the organizational factors. That is, what is the key objective or the goal of your organization plays a very important role in determining of the pricing. That is, are you looking at a competitive position, or are you looking at being the market leader, or are you looking at a niche market, or you're looking at a mass product? What kind of a competitive position or marketing segmentation and positioning for your firm you're looking for? That is, what is the key objective of your firm plays a very important role in determining the pricing decision. Second being the marketing mix. Marketing mix, as already said, is a combination of all the four P's, that is product, price, place and promotion, in the right way so as to best meet the needs of the target market. Marketing mix plays a very important role in the pricing, because we need to take in the cost of the product, we need to take in the cost of the promotion and the distribution strategies while coming up with our pricing decisions. The third being product differentiation. Product differentiation is in terms of how different is our product offering from those of the competitors already in the market or from any other products which we are already offering. If a product is very differentiated in terms of features or in terms of usage, we can definitely go for a higher pricing level and vice versa. The next being the cost of the product. Obviously, when we are setting up a new product or introducing a new product into the market, we are doing with the sole aim of profit maximization. Profit maximization would only happen when we've covered up all our costs and added a profit margin to it. Hence, the cost of the product, that is the cost of your raw materials, the cost of your supplies, and the entire costing which goes into the making of the product plays a very important role in determining the pricing decision. If we can have economies of scale, that is large-scale production, the costs tend to go low, and hence we can have lower pricing. And finally, the marketing objectives. Saying in terms that what are your key objectives in terms of marketing? Yet again, are you trying to look at a mass market, or you're looking only at a niche market? Are you looking at a huge geographical region, or are you looking at a very small area? Having said that, let's move to the external factors affecting the pricing decision. The first being the demand. As already said, demand and pricing are inversely related to each other. The lower the price, higher is the demand. Higher the price, lower is the demand. Hence, the demand in the market plays very important role in determining a price. If there is huge demand in the market for our product, we can definitely set up a little comparatively higher pricing levels. And if the demand of a product is not very high because it's already being met by the competitors, we have to set up low pricing for the same. Second being the competition. That is, whether is it a monopoly competition or an oligopoly or a monopolistic competition, the type of competition for our product existing in the market plays a very important role in determining our pricing. If we are the monopoly and there is no other competition, we can definitely go for a very high level of price setting. Whereas if it is an oligopoly, pricing, as already discussed initially, is set by formation of cartels and pools, and you're not the sole decision maker for the pricing. The next being our suppliers. That is, the suppliers for our raw materials, supplier for all other kind of resources which go into the production of the product. The pricing at which the suppliers come and the location of the suppliers also play a very important decision in the pricing strategy. The next being the economic conditions of the market, in terms whether it's a boom or a recession, whether it's an inflation, or what are the interest rates in the market. All of these play a very important role in determining the pricing decision. The next being the buyers, that is the buyer's trend, fashion, taste, preferences. All of these play an important role in determining your pricing. And finally, the government. The government plays a role in terms of its taxation, in terms of the interest rates, the borrowing and the lending rates, and etc. Having said that, let's move to the next one, that is the laws of price sensitivity and consumer psychology. Well, the first one under that is reference price effect. A buyer's price sensitivity for a given product increases the higher the product's price relative to perceived alternatives. Perceived alternatives can vary by buyer segment, by occasion, and other factors. The second one being difficult comparison effect. Buyers are less sensitive to the price of a known or a more reputable product when they have difficulty in comparing it to its potential alternatives. The third being switching cost effect. The higher the product specific investment a buyer must make to switch the suppliers, the less price sensitive that the buyer is when choosing the between different alternatives. Next being the price quality effect. Buyers are less sensitive to price, the more the higher prices signal higher quality. Products for which the effect is particularly relevant include image products, exclusive products, and products with minimal cues for quality. The next being expenditure effect. Buyers are more price sensitive when the expense accounts for a large percentage of buyers' available income or the budget. Next being end benefit effect. The effect refers to the relationship a given purchase has to the large overall benefit and is divided into two parts, that is the derived demand and the price proportion cost. The more sensitive the buyers are to the price of the end benefit, the more sensitive they will be to the prices of the products that contribute to that particular benefit. This is called as derived demand. The next being price proportion cost. Price proportion cost refers to the percentage of the total cost of the end benefit accounted for by a given component that helps to produce the end benefit. Example, think of CPU and the PCs. The smaller the given component share of the total cost of the end benefit, the less sensitive the buyers would be towards the component's price. Next being shared cost effect. The smaller the portion of the purchase price buyers must pay for themselves, the less price sensitive that they will be. Next being fairness effect. Buyers are more sensitive to the price of a product when the price is outside the range they perceive as fair or reasonable given the purchase context. And finally, the last one is the framing effect. Buyers are more price sensitive when they perceive the price as a loss rather than a foregone gain, and they have greater price sensitivity when the price is paid separately rather than being paid as a part of the bundle.